In this video, we are going to review the methodology of gateway cloning. Gateway cloning is based on the site-specific recombination machinery used by phage lambda to integrate its genome into E. coli. The phage lambda, in an attempt to outwit the restriction enzyme defense of E. coli, evolved a lysogenic pathway. In this situation, the phage uses site-specific recombination to integrate itself into the bacterial genome and hide from the restriction enzyme defense. The enzymes used by phage lambda to integrate and later excise itself are the basis of gateway cloning. In this diagram, you can see that the integration system involves specific DNA sequences found on the phage at P sites, as well as sites found on the bacterial genomic target at B. Recombination between the B and P elements results in new recombination sequences flanking the inserted phage DNA. After insertion, the recombination sequences are now called at L and at R. If the phage senses that the bacteria is under stress, it will excise itself. Upon excision, at L and at R are converted back to at P and at B, and the phage DNA is removed from the bacterial chromosome. The phage then begins its lytic growth cycle. The gateway system uses both the integration and excision reactions to create an alternative to restriction enzyme cloning. Since gateway cloning is moving elements from one plasmid to another, they do not refer to integration and excision, but rather the BP reaction, going from BP to LR sites, and the LR reaction, going from LR to BP sites. These two recombination events are perpetually reversible. An important detail we will cover fully when we get into the details of gateway cloning is that there are actually five different specific LR sites with corresponding BP sites. At L1 can only recombine with at R1, creating B1 and P1, and so forth. The significance of this specificity will become clear later. Gateway cloning is built on a series of plasmids called entry vectors and destination vectors. Entry vectors are used to capture a gene or gene fragment of interest to create an entry clone. When performing gateway cloning, you will create one or more entry clone. 1 to 4 entry clones can be introduced into a destination vector. The outcome is your desired expression clone. The system is designed to allow you to rapidly and easily rearrange multiple entry clones without the need to reclone the actual insert. The specific purpose of the entry vector is to create a clone of interest that is flanked with the at-L sites. The at-L sites, which target recombination to create your expression clone. Any number of molecular approaches can be used to capture your fragment of interest into your desired entry vector. These will be discussed in detail later. Alternatively, several libraries of entry clones are available, such as the mouse, yeast, and worm Orpheum libraries. Each of these contain open reading frame clones captured in a gateway entry vector. These libraries and their individual clones are commercially available. Once you have your entry clone or clones, you need to create your expression clones. You will choose the appropriate destination vector. Destination vectors are engineered to accommodate everything from mammalian expression to two-hybrid screening. The identical LR reaction is used no matter which expression clone you are building. The examples shown in this image are based on the transfer of a single open reading frame into various destination vectors. Gateway technology also allows you to combine multiple entry clones into a single expression vector in one step. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.